guys. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, teacher.
Okay.
Good
afternoon, teacher. Good afternoon, ka. Good afternoon, ka. Okay, so how are you guys? How are you today?
I'm good.
Okay, that's good to hear. Welcome back to our math class. And our topic for this afternoon will be about word problems on addition and subtraction. So as you can remember, our topic last time was about mixed equations, right? You know already how to add and subtract numbers. And you can do already both, right? At the same time. Okay, so what are word problems? Okay, word problems. A word problem is a few sentences describing a real life scenario where a problem needs to be solved by a way of mathematical calculation. Okay, what does it mean? When we say real life scenario, we are using word problems. For example, when you go to a store and you want to buy something. Okay, so your problem now is how much should be the change, how much should be for the prices of the item that you are buying, right? So you have to do the addition, okay? And you can also have subtraction, how much money left in your pocket. Okay, so that is now example of the word
problem. โจทย์นะคะเรื่องราวเกี่ยวกับโจทย์ปัญหานะคะนักเรียนโจทย์ปัญหาทางคณิตศาสตร์นะคะก็คือจะมีประโยคนะคะประโยคแล้วก็ข้อความนะคะทางคณิตศาสตร์เนี่ยที่ให้เราหาคําตอบด้วยวิธีการนะคะด้วยการแก้สมการถ้าเป็นโจทย์ปัญหาการบวกหรือการลบนะคะเดี๋ยวเรามาดูสเต็ปต่อไปว่าวิธีการแก้โจทย์ปัญหาทางคณิตศาสตร์เนี่ยทําอย่างไรบ้างนะคะ
Okay, we have steps to follow in solving word problems. Okay, so first thing, you need to read. Okay, read the problem, not only once, but you can read the problem many times so that you can understand the problem. Okay, so after reading, and if you already understand what is the problem all about, we have 5 steps to follow.Okay, so you need to remember these 5 steps so that you can answer easily. Okay, first we have to identify the problem. Okay, you need to identify the problem. By the way, identify the problem.
แปลว่าอะไรแปลว่าอะไรคะนักเรียนก็คือนะคะเป็นการระบุปัญหานะคะดูที่โจทย์และก็ดูว่าโจทย์ต้องการทราบอะไรนะคะให้เราดูก่อนว่าโจทย์ต้องการทราบอะไรในสเต็ปที่1นะคะ
โอเค First thing you have to know what are you looking for okay you can answer the following questions what is asked in the problem okay what is asked in the problem what is the problem or what are you looking for okay it is the question in the problem it isThe problem that you are going to answer. Okay, so you have to identify the problem. Number 2, you have to gather information. Gather information. Gather information. You have to get information. You have to get data from the problem. Okay, you can ask the questions. What are the given numbers? Okay, in the problem, you have to look for the numbers. Okay, what are the numbers that you can see in the problem? So this is number 2. You have to look for the numbers. Sometimes you get many numbers, more than 3 numbers like that. And other informations also, we have keywords. Okay, keywords. These are the clues.Clues, are you gonna add or are you gonna subtract the numbers? Okay?
ค่ะตรงนี้ก็คือดูว่าโจทย์ให้อะไรมาบ้างนะคะให้ ให้อะไรเรามาบ้างนะคะในโจทย์นะคะ
Okay, so that is number 2. Now if you have already the information, so you have the number and the keywords, you can now make an equation. Okay, again, what are equations? What are equations? Equations just like
คำถาม
สมการค่ะก็คือสร้างสมการนะคะหรือประโยคสัญลักษณ์นั่นเองนะคะ
Okay, very good. The equation, for example, the number sentence. Okay, for addition, you have to write plus sign. Okay, and for subtraction, you have to use minus sign. Okay, so that is number 3. Okay, if you already have the equations, step 4, you have to solve. Okay, solve แปลว่าอะไร Solve แปลว่าอะไร
แปลว่าอะไรคะแปลว่าแสดงวิธีทำนะคะนักเรียน
Okay, so we can now start answering. If it is addition, you can now start adding the numbers. If it is subtraction, you can now start subtracting the numbers. Or if it is mixed equation, you can now start doing the operations. Okay? And number 5, you have to verify your answer. Verify your answer or you have to give your answer. Okay, give your answer not only the number, but it should be in a sentence. Okay?
ก็คือตรวจคำตอบนะคะนักเรียนจากขั้นตอนที่1 2 3 4นะคะมาขั้นตอนสุดท้ายคือการตรวจคำตอบนั่นเองนะคะ
Okay, so can we read one more time the 5 steps?
Identify problem.
Okay, the problem. Okay, you understand already identify the problem, right? And number
Okay, number two,
what is number two? Okay, that's right. Gather information. What does it mean in Thai? Do you understand already? Gather information. Gather, you have to get what? Get what? Get?
ขั้นที่สองคืออะไรนะคะ?
Get อะไรนะ? What do you want? Numbers, okay. You have to get the numbers in the problem and the keywords. Don't forget, make equations.
Make equations.
Okay. Next, solve and then answer. Okay. So before we start with the example, I will give you some keywords. Okay. Keywords. What does it mean? These are the clue. Okay, clue. Do you know what are clues?
Okay. Clues ก็คือเป็นคีย์เวิร์ดที่เราใช้นะคะในคณิตศาสตร์นะคะ clues ก็คือ addition ก็คือดูคีย์เวิร์ดของการบวกแล้วก็ subtraction ก็คือคีย์เวิร์ดในการลบนะคะโจทย์การลบนั่นเองนะคะ
The keywords will help you think how to answer the problem. Is it addition or is it subtraction? Okay, so here are some keywords for addition.
นักเรียนคำนี้อ่านว่าอะไรคะใครจำได้บ้าง Keyword ของการบวก
plus. If you can use the word plus in the problem, means addition, right? What else? Add. Okay, you see the word add in the problem, it means addition, right? Next word, sum.
Sum,
what is that? It means you have to answer in addition. This is the answer for addition, right? So you have to add. Next word. Number two. Total. แปลว่าอะไร? You have
อะไรคะ?
เต่า
No, ไม่ใช่เต่าค่ะ Total addition แปลว่าอะไรคะ? Keyword ของ addition.รวมนะคะเป็นคำว่ารวมนะคะ
okay. total not turtle okay total when you read the word total it means you have to do addition okay and next one the word more okay the word more
more
แปลว่า
อะไรคะนักเรียน
more
ลับ
มากใช่ไหมคะ
มาก
มาก okay next is the word combine okay combine
combine
put
น้อย
combine
combine แปลว่ารวมนะคะนักเรียนรวมนะคะ
if you can read the word combine in the problem it means addition right and increase increase okay increase แปลว่าอะไรโอเคอิน
คร
ี
ม
ปวด
เพิ่มขึ้นนะคะสเปซเพิ่มขึ้นนะคะนักเรียน
โอเค and if you can read the word all then together it means addition โอเค all together
okay.
คือรวมทั้งหมดนะคะ
now what about for subtraction we have the words minus okay minus
minus
Then, if you can read the word subtract.
Minus, minus.
Subtraction.
Subtraction.
Then, if you can read the word left, how much left? Left, แปลว่า
left.
Left. แปลว่าเหลือนะคะคำนี้นะคะนักเรียนแปลว่าเหลือนะคะ
โอเค Then, left over. How much is left over? Okay, so the same subtraction.
Left.
leftover คือน้อยลงนะคะ
okay then decrease the number it means you have to subtract okay decrease
wow
แปลว่าอะไรคะนักเรียน decrease เพิ่มขึ้น decrease
เพิ่มขึ้น
เพิ่มขึ้น
decrease แปลว่าอะไรคะลดลงนะคะเพราะว่าเป็น keyword นะคะ
ลดลง
Then we have the words take away. Take away. You have to minus again. Take away. You have to get.
เอาออกนะคะเอาออกนะคะ
Take away and then fewer. Okay, fewer, fewer. It means also you have to.Subtract. Okay, so at least you have to be familiarized with these words so that later when you can read the following words, you know what to do. You know you're gonna add or you have to subtract. Okay? So if you are, let us have example. Okay, so I have here example number one. Okay, I have here the problem.Okay, so who can read the problem? Who wants to read the problem?
ใครอ่านได้บ้างคะนักเรียน
Who can read the problem? Okay, let us read all together. Okay, in Thailand,
Thailand, the number of
babies born
in one was
2,000.
2,817.
The number of babies.
The number of baby birth
is
16,992.
Okay. What was?
Was.
The total number of babies born. Okay, so this is now our problem. The first thing you need to understand the problem. Okay, can you tell me in Thai what do you understand about the problem?
นักเรียนคะประโยคนี้
โจทย์ปัญหานี้
นะคะคืออะไรคะในประเทศไทยมีจำนวนทารกที่เกิดในสัปดาห์ที
่1
นะคะจำนวน 42,817 คนแล้วก็ในสัปดาห์ที่2เกิด 16,992 คนโจทย์ถามว่า what was the total number of babies born
okay so this is total, now
total คือเป็นส่วนของการอะไรคะ
เหลือเลย
ไม่เหลือค่ะนักเรียนโชว์ทั่ว
บอล
ผลรวมเขาอยากทราบว่าจำนวนทารกที่เกิดมีทั้งหมดกี่คนนั่นเองนะคะ
โอเค so you already understand the problem so you are now ready to do the steps Okay, so step one, again, what is step one? Step one, we have to identify the problem. What are we looking for? What are we looking for? What is asked in the problem? What is the question? Okay, who can tell me? What is asked in the problem? What are we looking for? That is step one. Okay, who can answer? What is the question? Okay, when you say question, it can have a question mark. Can you see any question mark in the problem? Can you see? What is asking the problem? So we are looking for what was the total number?
What was the total number of babies born?
Okay, so that is our problem for today. Okay, so we have to look for the number of babies. So this is our problem. Step one, what was the total number of babies born? Okay, then step two, gather information. Okay, gather information. Information like given numbers.
What are the
given numbers
and
keywords? Keywords. How many numbers you can see in the problem? Okay, we have there the problem on top. How many numbers can you see? How many
in numbers? Thailand?
Numbers. What are the numbers? We have this one, right? 144. Okay,
142,870.
Okay, so we have there one number and two number. Okay, so we have two numbers in the problem. So we have to write the first number is
42,870.
Okay, so what is that? What is this number? This is the number of
baby born
in week one. Okay, so you have to write it here. 42,870 is the number of babies born in week one.
Okay.
What is the next number? The next number is
16,992.
Okay, so you have to write 16,992. So what is that number? That is the number of babies born in week two. Okay, so you have to write two here. That is
step ที่สองก็คือสิ่งที่โจทย์ให้มานะคะนักเรียน
Okay, so the first number we already know it is the number of babies in week one, and 16,992, the number of babies born in week two. All right. So now, can you see any keywords? Can you see any keywords? Anybody? Can you see any keywords? Any keywords, Mike? Can you see any keywords?
คำว่าอะไรคะ
keywords for addition. Can you see any keywords?
No.
For subtraction, are you sure? No. What about this word? Is total. Keyword total, is it addition or subtraction? Total. แต่ว่า
addition
total แปลว่ารวมใช่ไหมคะนักเรียนก็เป็นคีย์เวิร์ดของการบวกใช่ไหมคำว่ารวมนะคะคือการบวกนะคะ
ใช่ค่ะ
โอเค step 3 for step 3 you have to make or write the equation. Okay, who can now tell me what will be the equation? What will be our number sentence? Okay, it is already addition. Okay, you have now the numbers and you know that it is addition. Okay, so therefore, you have to write 42,817 plus, right? Plus, why? because it is addition. Plus
16,992.
Okay, so this is now our equation. Okay?
ก็คือ equation ก็คือการเขียนสมการนะคะหรือประโยคสัญลักษณ์นะคะนักเรียนสเต็ปที่3นะคะ
Okay, so you have now the equation. So, okay, have to write again the equation. And then you are now ready for step 4. What is step 4? Step 4, you have now, you are going to solve. Solve แปลว่าอะไร? Solve.
แปลว่าอะไรคะ?แสดงวิธีทำนะคะนักเรียนการแสดงวิธีหาคำตอบนั่นเองนะคะ
Okay, so you have now to add you have now the numbers then you are now ready to add the numbers Okay, so let us answer all together 7 plus 2
plus 2 equal 9
9, okay that's right Next, 1 plus 1 9
9 equals 10.
10, right? 0, carry?
Carry 1.
Okay, 1 plus 8 equals?
9.
9 plus 9 equals? 18. 18, okay, so you have to write 8 and carry 1, right? So 1 plus 2
plus
equals
2 equals 3.
3 plus 6
equals
9. Okay, 9. Then 4 plus 1 equals?
Plus 1 equals 5.
5. Okay, that's right. So our answer is?
59,809.
Okay, that's right. So this is now our answer. Now for step 5. Okay, so we have here now step 4. So you already asked. Okay, so for step 5, you have to verify your answer. You have to give your answer in a sentence.Okay, sentence แปลว่าอะไร
sentence แปลว่าอะไรคะนักเรียน
ประโยค
นะคะ
ประโยค
โจทย์นะคะสเต็ปที่5นะคะก็คือการตรวจคำตอบนะคะ
Okay, so we are looking for again what is our problem we are looking for the total number
of babies
born Okay, so we get the answer.So you have to write your answer like this. You have to write this one, okay?
The total number of babies born
was 59,809. Okay? So that is now your final answer. Okay, is that clear? So you just have to write...The sentence, your answer in a sentence. The total number of babies born was 59,809. Okay, do you understand? Okay, so that is step 1 to step 5. Any question about this one?
มีคำถามไหมคะนักเรียน
No.
มีนะให้นักเร
ีย
นให้นักเรียนจำสเต็ปไว้นะคะว่ามี5 step แล้วก็ keyword นะคะของอะไรนะ addition กับ subtract นะคะว่า keyword เนี่ยใช้คำว่าอะไรบ้างถ้าเจอในโจทย์ปัญหาเราจะได้ดูว่าโจทย์นั้นจะให้เราเป็นแค่สมการการบวกหรือการลบนั่นเองนะคะให้ดูที่ keyword นะคะนักเรียน
โอเคSo, let us have more examples so that you can understand deeper, you can understand better. Okay, so are you ready for example number 2? Okay, for number 2. Okay, remember the steps again. Okay, so we have here, let me read the problem for you. A chocolate factory.
A chocolate factory.
14,000.
Candy of
if
9,124
candy
were sold.
How many candy were left in the factory? Okay, so do you understand the problem? แปลว่าอะไร? Who can tell me? Anybody? What is the problem all about? Do you understand the problem? You need to understand, okay? The most important thing is that you have to understand the problem. Okay, a chocolate factory made แปลว่า
อะไรคะ? แปลว่าทำหรือผลิตนั่นเองนะคะ?โรงงานช็อกโกแลตนะคะผลิตแคนดี้ก็คือลูกกวาดนะคะลูกอมลูกกวาดเนี่ย
ลูกกวาด
14,894 ชิ้น
and then sold แปลว่าอะไร
sold แปลว่าอะไรคะขายถ้านะคะ if
ขาย
โรงงานเนี่ยขายลูกกวาดไป 9,124 ชิ้นนะคะ
okay so question our problem is how many candies were left
how many candies were left in
the factory แปลว่าอะไร how many candies were left
นักเรียนดูหาคีย์เวิร์ดก่อนนะคะหาคีย์เวิร์ดซิว่าโจทย์นี้ต้องการทราบอะไร
okay how many candies were left แปลว่าอะไร how many candies were left in the factory แปลว่าอะไร
แปลว่าเหลือใช่ไหมคะโรงงาน
เหลือ
โรงงานจะเหลือ
โรงงานจะเหลือเท่าไหร่
จะเหลือเท่าไหร
่ okay so let us now answer step 1 what is our problem step 1 identify the problem okay so what are we looking for
we how many candy will live in the valley
Okay, in the factory. So that is our problem.
That's
how many candies were left in the factory?
Left in the factory.
Okay. That is step one. Okay, step two. Gather information. Can you see any numbers in the problem? Any numbers? How many numbers you can see?
14.
How many numbers? 1 and 2, right?
This one, 14,894 and 9,124.
Okay, so that is our given numbers. Okay, 14,894. That is the number of candies made. By the factory, all right? And the second number is 9,124. So that is the number of candies sold. Sold by what? They sold, okay? So we have now. Okay, can you see any keywords in the problem? Keywords. What are we going to do? Add or subtract? Now, Mr. Mary? What will be our operation? Okay.
Keyword ของมิสเตอร์อะไรคะ?
Mr. EQ, what do you think? What is our keyword?
Left.
Okay, that's right. We have the word left. Okay, we have the word left. แปลว่าอะไร?
Left แปลว่าอะไรคะ, นักเรียน?
เหลือ
Okay, so therefore our equation should be.Minus, right? So you have to write 14,894
minus 9,214.
Okay, so you know already the equation. So for step 4, you have to solve. So what will be the answer? 14,894 minus Okay, so 4 minus 4
equals 4 minus 4 equals 0.
Okay, 0. Okay, you can answer. 9 minus 2 equals
9 minus 7. 2 equals 7.
8 minus 1
8 minus
equals
1 equals 7.
Okay, then 14 minus 9 equals
9 equals 5.
5. Okay, so the answer is 5,770. Okay, so when writing the answer, you have to write, what are we looking for again? The number of candies left in the factory. Okay, so you have to write here. There were
5,770
candies left in the factory. Okay, so you need to write your answer like this. Okay, to write your answer like this, you need to go back to your problem. Okay, how many candies were left in the factory? Then you have to write in a sentence. There were 5,770 candies left in the factory. Any question about this step? Okay, this time we have subtraction, right? Because of the keyword left. Okay, so we still have 3 minutes more. I still have one example, but the time isn't enough. Okay, so we have homework for today. Okay, any question by the way?
No. ในสเต็ปไหนไหมถามได้เลยนะคะนักเรียน
เย้เย้สเต็ปเลย
โอเคไม่มีนะ
yes
okay no no question very good wow so this is our practice but maybe we can have it next time okay so for your homework you have to write your answer like this okay you have to answer like this on your book You have to write from A to E. A, what is asking the problem. Letter B, the given. Letter C, the equation. You have to write like this. And you have
to write your answer.
Yes, Mr. PQ.
It's a paper.
This one is your practice, supposedly. But there is no more time. So I'll just show you that you will answer your homework like this.
ตรงนี้เป็นกิจกรรมนะคะตอนแรกเลยทีเชอร์จะให้นักเรียนทำกิจกรรมด้วยกันแต่ว่าเวลานะคะเวลาเหลือนิดเดียวทีเชอร์ก็เลยโชว์ข้อนี้ให้ดูนะคะเพื่อที่ให้นักเรียนดูขั้นตอนแต่ละสเต็ปแล้วเดี๋ยวเราไปทำการบ้านนะคะมีการบ้านในหนังสือให้นะคะ
โอเค so this is how you are going to answer right and your homework will be this oneAnswer page 45. Okay, please look for your book. Turn page 45 and answer letter A and letter B only. Right? So letter A, you got to answer from letter A to letter E like this. A to letter E. Okay? And the same for letter B. You need to answer from letter A to letter E.
มีใครจะถามอะไรไหมคะนักเรียน
okay
no
no okay there is no question no. that's all for today thank you for listening I hope you understand something today okay thank you see you again on Friday goodbye everyone
dongi dongi
bye okay goodbye everyone
bye
bye bye